Now, Washington Mornings on the Mall. 105.9 FM. At AM 630.
WMAL. 837 on WMAL. Brian Wilson, Larry O'Connor. You're listening to the station where Washington comes to talk. On the line, Congressman Tom Price, a Republican from Georgia. He will be the vice chair of the House Budget Committee for the 113th Congress, and he is the chairman of the Republican Policy Committee. And last night, he voted against the bill that was sent over from the Senate, the so-called McConnell-Biden compromise. Congressman, thank you for joining us. Why did you vote with it? Why did you vote against it?
Happy New Year to you. Well, at the end of the day, these kinds of bills are never all good or all bad. My assessment was that it ultimately raised taxes and didn't decrease any spending. In fact, it increased spending. So we increased the deficit and raised taxes, and I thought that was not a prescription for getting our economy back on the right track.
And you were joined by 150 other Republicans who felt that way. You voted against your Speaker of the House.
Well, I think if you look at the vote is really fascinating. If you look at the votes that were yes on the Republican side, there were 85 of them, and 70 of them come from blue states. So I really think, and I've been talking about this for a couple months now, that I think this is a red state, blue state issue. When we were talking about previous, quote, solutions, it really broke down in our conference between those Republicans who were from red states and those who were from blue states. It's a different conversation that we need to have within our own conference as we move forward with the kinds of positive solutions that I think are out there.
Well, Representative Price, given the fiasco over Speaker Boehner's Plan B proposal 2 weeks ago, and then what happened last night with Speaker Boehner joining the Democrats to push this through, is there a leadership crisis in the Republican caucus?
I don't think so, and I don't think if you talk to the Majority Leader Cantor and Whit McCarthy and to the Speaker, I don't think so. Look, this was step back and realize why we were in the situation we were in last night. One, the president won the election, and he was adamant about raising taxes. He continues to be. So in this instance, he was going to get his tax increase. Two, we're the minority party in Washington. We control the House. We don't control the Senate or the presidency. And three, the reason this became a crisis is because of Senate dysfunction. The House Republicans had acted last year responsibly three or four times on these specific items. The Senate refused to act. The first time that they voted on these issues was Monday night.
All right, so we didn't do a thing with this bill of any significance to reduce the deficit.
No, in fact, we increased the deficit by almost $4 trillion over a 10-year period of time, which is why I believe now the debate shifts positively to spending reductions. And the leverage points are clearly the sequester, which was the spending cuts that were put into place or by law put into place in the Budget Control Act. Two, the debt ceiling debate, and three, the continuing resolution funding the government. All of those things come up within the next 3 months, and this is going to be the battle royale to get us on a path to a balanced budget and paying off our debt.
Well, how do you, though you control the House, the Senate is controlled by the Democrats, of course, the president is a Democrat, how do you overcome that?
Well, at some point you've got to draw a line in the sand, and we have been unwilling as a conference to do that, and I think that's where we will come out of this debate and out of this this process, recognizing that the president has not been an honest broker and has not been willing to put any spending reductions on the table. And that's exactly what has to occur in order for us to get our economic fiscal house in order and the economy rolling again, not just so that the economy rolls again. The consequences of that are that people find jobs and that dreams are able to be realized once again, as opposed to the doldrums that we find ourselves in right now.
Are you saying you would be against raising the debt limit?
I think you have to say, in order for any increase in the debt ceiling to occur, there has to be fundamental spending reductions, at least a dollar for dollar, and along with the continuing resolution, the funding of the government, we've got to have fundamental, positive, principled reform to save, strengthen, and secure Medicare and Medicaid, which are the biggest cost drivers.
Representative Tom Price from Georgia is our guest. And Congressman Price, I think our listeners can read between the lines here. You're saying this is a red state, blue state issue. We've got leadership from blue states. You're from a red state. You're saying that, yes, we do need to draw the line in the sand. Congressman Price, someone has to be drawing that line, and we don't see anybody drawing the line. And we know that the president isn't negotiating as an honest broker. It hasn't taken us 4 years to figure it out. I know it hasn't taken you 4 years to figure it out. figure it out. I mean, let's face it. We're not getting, the Republican Party, that is not getting the kind of negotiating might that they should be getting from the top leadership. And it showed last night with the vote, the fact that you voted against the Speaker of the House. There needs to be a change here in the party, doesn't it?
I think you will see a significant change in perspective and a significant change in strategy, and it'll come from the maturation of the now sophomore class, the 87 new folks that came last year, and the 35 new folks who are coming to the Republican conference right now, the vast majority of whom are remarkably successful in their own right in the private sector, and bring a wealth of experience and a can-do attitude about how you get this government under control.
We're hearing reports that there are 20 or more Republicans who are ready to block the Speaker's election tomorrow. Have you heard anything about that?
I don't know anything about that.
And I know you're not running for Speaker, but if something happens, and if for some reason, maybe John Boehner just decides he doesn't want to keep herding these cats for two more years, and there's a leadership vacuum, would you be interested in stepping forward? A lot of people have mentioned your name.
Well, there's this palace intrigue is wonderful for these kinds of discussions, but the fact of the matter is what we need to do is get down to business and get spending under control in this country and positively solve the challenges that we've got.
So, I agree, but you didn't answer the question.
Well, you're right.
Would you be interested in stepping forward if someone asks you? I mean, you come from a red state. You come from Georgia. You're a doctor. You can address so many of the Medicare issues coming forward.
I think we need red state representation in both our leadership as well as the organizing committees that we have.
Something we don't have right now. All right, Congressman Price, thank you so much for joining us.
Congressman Tom Price, Republican from Georgia, greatly appreciate you joining us.
Take care.